Deputy Adams.
Concord, first of all, I also welcome the debate. I was going to raise it later under order of business. I'm also very mindful that there are victims and families affected by abuse watching us here today. Some of them have been in touch with my office. Sexual abuse and abuse of any kind is wrong. The abuse of a child is a particularly heinous crime. And the consequences for victims and their families are devastating. And we know this, having seen the human cost of abuse right across Irish society. Now, I have set out the circumstances in the north when there was no democratic civic policing service. I have acknowledged that the IRA sought to deal with some cases of abuse when asked to do so by families and victims. While IRA volunteers were acting, in my opinion, in good faith, the IRA was ill-equipped to deal with such matters. And IRA actions against sex offenders failed victims. And that is a matter of profound regret for me and other Republicans. So I'm acutely conscious that there may be victims who were let down or failed by the IRA's inability to resolve these cases. And as Uachtarán Sinn Féin, I want to apologise to those victims. Those who wish should come forward now and report their complaints to the appropriate authorities. And Garda Síochána, HSE in the north, and PSNI, or the social services, Cumhall Éascail, the HSE here in the south. And they will have Sinn Féin's full support in doing so. Secrecy has surrounded abuse in Ireland. It was taboo to discuss it, and some victims were very fearful to disclose. And the only way to face this problem is to support victims, to empower victims, in order that they will speak out. And to cover up child abuse is to deny the basic humanity of the victim and to shield the perpetrator. And it's an unthinkable act of cruelty. Now, Sinn Féin has not engaged in a cover-up of child abuse as some of our political enemies, including the Fianna Fáil leader and the Taoiseach, have alleged.
Question,
and this
please.
Accusation is a slur on thousands of decent Irish Republicans and Sinn Féin members. The Taoiseach and the Fianna Fáil leader should go to the Garda or the PSNI with any information you say you have now. Now.
Sorry, hold it.
Now, Republicans...
Sorry, Deputy, you're way over time.
I understand, Concordia. I understand, Concordia. Republicans are no different than any other Irish citizens. Like most parents, we do our best to protect our children, to keep them safe. And we've learned that ongoing vigilance and believing children is essential. And we know that reporting quickly and to the right channels is the way to seek and to achieve justice. So, Taoiseach, while I welcome a fully comprehensive debate here, as opposed to the sleeving way you and the Fianna Fáil leader have come to us.
Sorry, Deputy.
Will you accept that these matters, serious, difficult matters, need to be dealt with in a victim-centred way by the appropriate authorities and not politicised as they have been in this chamber?
Let's not forget that the central issue here is that a young woman was raped, was sexually abused, was required to go before her abuser and three other men from the IRA. Your deputy leader doesn't believe this. Your deputy leader has blind allegiance to you as leader of the party, while a young woman with her courage and her bravery is not afraid to speak out. In the last week, she has had numbers of others belonging to the same organization who have come forward to her, who have been contacting her about similar stories. I hope that these people have the courage to speak out as well. I would say, Deputy Adams, your next question, you might confirm whether you know, as leader of your party in Uachtarán Sinn Féin, whether Maria Cahill was required to attend in a room with three men and her abuser, all members of the IRA, and that a second meeting took place some months afterwards. And in the intervening period, she was not allowed to go to the PSNI or to the police. And you might confirm from your information, from associates who are or were members of the IRA, whether you are aware of any people who were moved down to this jurisdiction, to Donegal or to Louth, who were involved in sexual abuse of women in Northern Ireland, and who are still in this jurisdiction. You might indicate to the House whether you know anything about any of that, because I think the story that Maria Cahill has to tell is not just powerful, it will have serious consequences.
Well, Maria Cahill has made serious allegations, and you have met with Maria Cahill and you've listened to her allegations. Will you now facilitate a meeting with those that she accuses? These are named people. Now that you have set yourself up to make judgment in this, will you bring into Oireachtas and Oireachtas the people who have named? Bring them in.
Please. Thank you.
Bring them in and ask them the questions that you are asserting as fact. I refute the allegations that have been made about me and about other Sinn Féin members who assure me that all they did in their engagements and their conversations and their work with Maria Cahill was to help them. Now,
sorry, would you please put your question?
No, Sean Curia.
Please put your question. Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah. If you treated the Taoiseach and the leader of Fianna Fáil like that yesterday.
I beg your pardon. I try and keep order to the best of my ability, and you know that very well.
Well,
there's no need for those snide comments.
I'm not making snide comments. Let me get to the point. You have made accusations against members of Sinn Féin. Some of these were subject to court proceedings. Will you meet with those people? Will you meet with me? Will you put to me the assertions that have been put, and listen, because you have not listened.
Thank you. We're over time. Thank you.
I've already refuted the allegations made. I don't know who's not listening here. So, Taoiseach, it's a very simple proposition. You have heard Maria Cahill's story, and all of those who from Sinn Féin have met with Maria Cahill, accept and acknowledge that she was abused, accept that she was traumatised. Now, she then puts a particular version of
Thank
what
you.
Occurred. Will you listen? Will you? These are not nameless, anonymous people. These are decent people.
Thank you.
Will you meet with them and listen to their version of the story and then make a judgment
Thank
on
you.
These matters?
Debbie Adams, I find it absolutely unbelievable that you would come into this House of Parliament and say that a man who raped a woman, who sexually abused her, is a decent person.
Sorry.
I don't stand.
What are you to tell me? This is a debate. Allegations are made across the floor here. I can't judge on every allegation made. Please allow the Taoiseach to continue. You had your chance.
Deputy Adams, let me be quite clear. There are very many decent people in the Sinn Féin party. Thank you. I asked you a question to confirm whether or not Maria Cahill was required to attend at a meeting with three gentlemen and her abuser. You say these are included among the people who are decent, decent people. Now, I think, Deputy Adams, you need to clarify that. I think you also need, without laughing about it, to clarify for people down here whether your associates in the IRA when it was informal session knew of people who were moved down to this jurisdiction, the so-called safe houses in this city, the so-called safe houses in other places south of here, to Donegal or to Louth, who were guilty of sexual abuse in Northern Ireland and were moved from that location because of fear of publicity. Are those people still here? Is this true?
Thank you.
Do you know any of the activities that they're involved in now? These are the most serious matters for everybody. Sexual abuse was rampant in many sectors in Irish society, not alone in paramilitary organisations. But you have responsibility for this, and we need to know, and we need to know the answers.
Thank you.
I'll facilitate a comprehensive debate here in the best way possible, and we can look at the opportunity for people to have their say. And I will meet with the four people that you refer to, that are named. I will meet with them, but I won't stand in judgment on them. I'll ask them the questions that you won't answer.
Deputy Murphy, thank you.